Should I hire a consultant or should I do the entire process all by myself? So many people ask me this question, but it's not possible for me to answer this question in one line. So I decided to make this video so I can explain it to you. Hopefully by the end of this video, you'll be able to decide if you should hire a consultant or do the entire process all by yourself. Hello friends, this is Shitanshu from Dream Abroad. If you want to immigrate to Canada or Australia without paying hefty fee to the consultants, please visit my channel. I've got tons of videos on the immigration process of both of these countries. I do upload videos almost every day now. So if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe it right now. Okay, there's a difference between a should or a can. Now, I'll tell you if you can do the entire process by yourself. By the end of this video, you'll be able to decide if you should be applying it by yourself or you should hire a consultant. Okay, consultants charge such a hefty amount for the consultancy fees. In India, they do charge from 70,000 rupees to even 1,50,000 rupees. And in different countries like UAE or US, they do charge from $3,000 to $5,000. Such a hefty amount. You can definitely save all of that money and you can use it in your early days of settlement in Canada, but you need to give some time. You need to understand that this is a visa process. It takes time, so you need to be patient as well. Now, there are some certain steps involved in this complete process. I'm talking about the express entry process, talking of the step one, your ECA, your education credential assessment, your IELTS. Now, all of these things can be done by yourself. You just need to fill, you know, simple forms, and obviously I'm sure you can do that, but you need to invest some time in it. You need to understand the process. That's very important. You know, without understanding the process, it's not possible for you to, you know, go through and just get a visa. It's not a tourist visa that you're getting. It's a permanent residency visa. They'll ask you a number of questions. You have to pass your English exam or your French exam. You know, there are different certain criteria which you need to fulfill, your proof of funds, your reference letters which you need to get, and obviously you cannot afford to make any of these things wrong. You just cannot make it wrong. You just cannot afford to do any mistakes. So you need to visit my channel. I'm not endorsing my channel here. You know, there are different other channels as well. There are so many blogs out there, you know, discussion groups out there. You can definitely do all of it by yourself. So let's say I talk of the first step, that is your ECA. Now your ECA is your education credential assessment. Obviously you need to go through WES, IQAS or any other organization to get your education credentials verified. Now you need to get a transcript, you need to send it along with your degree certificate to their office in Toronto or some other office of different organization. But you need to know how to do it. For that, you need to give some time. You need to do some research of your own. There are multiple things that you need to understand. I am doing this thing, you know, I'm making these videos for you guys so that it'll be easier for you in each and every step. I explain it to you, you know, probably for, if you talk of the Canadian immigration, I've made a video absolutely on every step of your immigration, how you have to do that, how you have to upload the documents, you know, questions regarding the proof of funds, questions regarding the reference letters. I've also given you some of the formats for that. You know, there's so many things actually involved and it does take time. You also need to be patient. And guys, the CIC website, you know, it's the official website of IRCC. You can visit there. Everything is mentioned over there. I do take help of that website to make videos, give information to you guys. There are different PNP programs. You can definitely go and visit their, you know, their websites. It's all there online. So you can definitely do all of it by yourself. But coming to the next point, should you hire a consultant? Okay, you should hire a consultant if you don't have time to do the research. If you just cannot go and fill up your forms, you know, it's very important to know that which services are provided to you by the fees that the consultants actually charge. They charge you, you know, 1 lakh rupees to do what? To fill up the forms for you, you know, to fill up your own details. they'll give up probably a different form to you and just copy and paste the same things in the official form. So is this not something that you can do by yourself? Some of these consultancies actually provide IELTS coaching. Some of them say that they'll be giving you, job references in Canada. I'm not very sure. I'm not going to comment, if this is right or wrong. I'll be making a different video of how these consultancies actually fool you. But in this video, I'm just going to tell you if you should hire a consultancy or not. So coming to that point again, if you don't have time to, fill up the forms, these consultancies will fill up those forms for you, the Express Entry form, the PNP EOI forms. They won't go and get the IELTS exam done for you, right? You have to write the exam by your own. The consultancies will be actually telling you the next step. Okay, first step, you have to do your ECA. Go and get your transcripts. They'll pack it in an envelope and they'll actually send it across to Toronto to get it verified. Can't you do that? The second step would be IELTS. They'll say, go and clear the exam, try to get the best bands possible. Maybe they would be providing coaching for that. You can get that coaching from outside of the consultancy also, just paying by 8,000 to 10,000 rupees. And also, if you're good in English, you can just go through YouTube videos, or maybe there's so much stuff already available online. You can do it yourself without even the coaching. But if you want the coaching, you can also go out and get that done. Get the coaching in less like 10,000 rupees. They'll tell you the next step is creating an Express Entry profile. Now, Express Entry profile is just a form. Can't you fill it by yourself? Just tell me. You can definitely do it. I'm sure all of you, if you are, dreaming of going abroad and settling over there, you are smart enough to do that. You can definitely fill up your own details and submit it. You can definitely do it by yourself. Okay, after you're done with your Express Entry profile, they'll actually ask you to wait for some time so that you can get your ITA if you've got a very good score. But if you've got a score of something around 400, which is not enough to get an ITA from the Federal Skilled Worker Program, in that case, they'll recommend you some of the PNP programs. Now, coming to PNPs, there are several PNPs, and obviously, if you want to do it by yourself, you need to know the entire process. Just go to their websites and fill up their EOI forms. If you score good in their ranking system, they'll send you the invitations. So it's so simple, especially the Canadian immigration is so simple to understand. There are some queries. I know you would be having some queries. There's so many portals out there. I've got my Dream Abroad Canada Facebook group. More than 10,000 people are there to help you. Just come over there, ask the same question, and I'm sure you'll be bombarded with answers. I'm not saying that they're all experts, but there are people who have cleared their IELTS. There are people who have actually cleared their ECA. There are people who have got their ITA as well. So there are people to help you out at every stage. And I'm also there to help you through my videos. I answer your queries in your comments. I'll be doing a meetup very soon if you have any queries. Hopefully very soon I'll be starting a live YouTube session so you can ask me questions live. And things like that. Okay, so cutting long story short, you should actually go through a consultant if you don't have time and you have 1,50,000 rupees in spare. You don't care about that money. If you have that, totally fine. Go hire a consultant. If you don't have time to go through the process, if you don't have time to ask your queries, if you don't have time to watch my videos, you can definitely go ahead and hire a consultant. What are the tips of hiring a consultant? What should be a good consultant and who's a bad consultant? I'll give you tips on that as well. I'll make a separate video. But for this video, just take my word on it that you can definitely do the entire process all by yourself. All you have to do is give your time to understand the process, watch my videos, watch other videos on YouTube, ask your queries. There are people out there to help you out. And you can definitely do all of this by yourself. So thank you guys for watching this video. I just hope that you will now have an understanding if you should hire a consultant or if you should actually do the entire thing by yourself. So if you like the video, please click the like button and share it with your friends if your friends have the same query. Also, if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe it right now.